In today's episode, I want to talk to you guys about some stuff that's going on out here in Cochise County, Arizona. So if you live out here or you're thinking about living out here, you don't want to miss today's episode. Welcome back. We are two rebels off grid. I am Keri. My other half is Doug. You might be wondering where he is, and Doug actually just went back to work. So we both have been job searching here recently, and Doug went back part-time. He is a chef by training, and he's working in a restaurant. So he's not working full-time, and hopefully I'm going to find something soon that isn't full-time either. So anyhow, we've been a little bit busy with that. And then, of course, I'm sure you all are aware there's this giant heat wave going on in a good portion of the country, and that includes us. So I'm coming to you from the car today because it's 100 again today, and I'm running the generator to keep the trailer cool, and it's just too loud down by the generator. So I drove up here and I'm sitting in my nice air-conditioned car, and I'm going to talk to you about what's going on out here in Cochise County. So there are some proposed changes that the county, the floodplain control department or something like that. Don't quote me on that, but I just found out about this. Doug and I were reading on it last night on one of the Facebook groups that we follow. And what they're proposing that basically the county be, the whole county be kind of like considered that it's sort of in a floodplain. And they're doing that because it's the easiest solution to some issues. And how that's basically going to impact everybody is that everybody will have to elevate anything they build in the future, houses, outbuildings, garages, sheds, whatever, you'll have to elevate them. I believe it's 2 feet. It might be 1 foot, but I actually haven't had time to dig into it quite yet. But I know, and just reading, just basic reading through it, this is maybe going to happen pretty soon. So if you're not in a floodplain, there's no reason to build your house elevated like that. So if you are in a floodplain, obviously you're going to want to build elevated. Or if you're close to a floodplain, sometimes you might be close and there's the potential of like a 100-year flood and it goes beyond the normal boundaries and gets to your house. Like if that's your situation, then yeah, of course, like you want to think about that. Floods are horrible. They destroy things and you don't want to have to deal with that. So, but to put the entire county under this change, I guess is what you call it. I believe it's a change in the building codes. I have copied the information that I got with the permission of the person that wrote it, and also have the information on the actual change that they want to make. And then a recommendation from this person on how it could actually be changed where it won't impact everybody, because it has everything to do with FEMA flood zones. So if you're in a FEMA flood zone, you should absolutely follow floodplain guidelines. Like, probably don't even build there actually. But if you do, and some people do, they just take precautions. They build elevated, or, you know, you've seen houses up on stilts and things like that. We don't see the reason for them needing to mandate that for everybody. We're sitting on top of our build site, and hopefully we're going to get started on this part of our construction soon. But we're on a hill. I mean, we're way up on a hill, and I'm not saying that we don't get floodwaters through this area. We do. We have washes. They start at the top of the hill and they come down the hill. It's very obvious where they are. We sometimes do get water that is, you know, standing water, never more than a half an inch, because it's we're on a hill, so it drains off really quickly. So the potential for us to have a flood is like, we're not building our house in a floodplain, and we're not building next to a wash. Like, we're in a very, you know, we've been monitoring it now for a year to make sure it doesn't do anything weird. But this is a change that's really going to impact people. The way you can get around it, they say in the documentation, is that you can hire an engineering firm to come out and prove that your property is not in a floodplain. But the estimate that I saw from one of the people that's talking about this was $10,000 for a 10-acre parcel for an engineering firm to come out and prove that you're not in a floodplain. So, you guys, do your own research. I am not a lawyer by any stretch of the imagination, but read through this stuff. I started reading through it. I need to read through it some more. I went ahead and posted the information that this gal had put up on Facebook that I want to share with you, because you can take the information and you can copy it and you can use it. I'm recommending that everybody write to the Board of Supervisors. There's three of them here in Cochise County, and they're the ones that do the voting and make the rules, and they are elected officials that are should be representing the people, right? I mean, that's what their job is. So if you go on our website, tworebelsoffgrid.com, and it's two spelled out, T-W-O, the number two, tworebelsoffgrid.com, right underneath the picture of the tractor, there's a big blue button and it says Cochise County Proposed Changes. Click on that and it will take you right to the document, and I've just copied it. It has all the Board of Supervisors' email addresses. It has what the proposed changes are. You can read through them and decide for yourself if you want to reach out or not. I am highly recommending that everybody weigh in on this, especially if, even if you haven't moved here yet, that's okay. If you have an interest in this county and you own property, or you will be owning property, you should speak your mind about it. So educate yourself on it. Don't take my word for it. Do your research. But I've put all the information that can get you what you need right on our website. So go there and check it out. And I also wanted to mention, I've been working on our website. I'm not a web designer, so I'm a little slow, but I've been doing some updates. And one of the things that I put on there is a resources tab. It's up along the top. There's like a menu bar across the top, and you'll see resources on there. We get a lot of questions about, where'd you get your cisterns? How do you get your water? Where do you get your propane from? So I decided to go ahead and start a resources page on there that lists out who we use. Like one of the companies that we've used from the time we moved here was Rockin' U Water Supply, or Water Delivery, and they are out of Benson, Arizona, and they're awesome. They're wonderful. We call and they come and deliver our water until we can get our rainwater harvesting stuff in place. And I just want to give shout outs to those local businesses that have given us outstanding service. So go on the website, tworebelsoffgrid.com, and you can look at the resources on there. And I've got their contact information in there and their phone numbers. So there's some good resources on there for people that are local, that are, you know, smaller businesses that we want to help support. So anyhow, thanks for tuning in today. I hope I didn't confuse you, but like I said, we just learned about this last night, and I'm going to start digging into it today. But I wanted to get a video up because I know there's a lot of you that watch that are either living in this area or getting ready to come live in this area, and this will impact you if this change is made. So take a look and check it out. And thanks for watching today, you guys. I know it's kind of a boring video, but we'll be putting another one up here soon. Okay, you guys take care. Hope you're staying cool wherever you are, and we'll see you soon.